大家好，我是 Cecilia， 我是香港大学专业进修学院英语科课程主任，我很高兴在网上和大家见面。在今天的疫情之下，我们的年度开放日今年是更改为在线模式，这个无疑是一个突破。我希望这个突破标志着很多很多其他不同类型的活动的开始，继续带来新的感觉。今天我们的活动是旨在介绍一个新的剑桥英语水平检测 Cambridge Assessment English Lingua Skill 领师，是很美丽的翻译。领师是剑桥大学的一项网上测试，检测我们的英语技能、阅读、听力、写作和口语，提供两样测试以配合不同的需要，包括实用英语检测和职场英语检测 Lingua Skill General 和 Lingua Skill Business。 详细的资料呢，当然是由两位剑桥大学的专家为大家讲解。现在让我介绍一下我两位嘉宾。一位呢是远在北京的田宁先生，田宁先生呢是剑桥大学英语考评部大中华区运营主管。還有坐在我身邊的歐浩銘先生，劍橋大學英語考評部大中華區高級業務發展經理。首先我想請田寧先生宣布活動的開始，作歡迎詞，然後和我們介紹劍橋大學和劍橋英語考評詳細的資料，然後歐先生就會介紹新的劍橋領師英語檢測，最後我就提供領師檢測的時間表。今天我們公佈是雙語的，劍橋大學的兩位嘉賓就用英語和大家介紹劍橋大學和劍橋檢測，而我就用中文講在香港的劍橋領師考測試的其他的詳情的。現在有請田寧先生，田寧先生在北京，我們將會放一個他預錄的短片。
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to join the HKU Space Open Day. My name is Ning Tian, the head of operation of Cambridge Assessment English, Great China. Today, I'm very glad to join the HKU Space Open Day and take this opportunity to share some information and some updates about Cambridge Assessment English and our cooperation with HKU Space.So I will conduct the first part to introduce some background about our organization, who we are and what we do. My colleague Darren will introduce some detailed information about our cutting edge new product, Lingua Skill, and our Lingua Skill agent, HKU Space, Cecilia,will introduce more Lingua Skill related course at the third part. And we will have around 10 to 15 minutes to pick up your question. So now let's start from the who we are. We are the Cambridge Assessment English, part of the University of Cambridge. We have a 160 years old history working in the assessmentresearch and as an assessment provider and organizer to provide the assessment and the exams and the test to the global English learners. Our mission is that we help people learn English and prove their skill to the world. Here is our logo. As you can see, we have the same shield like Cambridge, the University of Cambridge. And here is our name about the Cambridge Assessment English. So what's our detailed relationship with the Cambridge University and the Cambridge Assessment? So here we are. The Cambridge Assessment is a non-teaching department of the University of Cambridge. So they have four exam boards under the Cambridge Assessment.They are the Cambridge Assessment Admission Testing, so we call it ATS, and the Cambridge Assessment English. Sometimes we call it Cambridge English, and the Cambridge Assessment International Education. Sometimes we call it the CIE or the Cambridge International. And we also have a local Oxford Cambridge RSA in the UK. They provide the local A-level test to the UK domestic students. So as per I mentioned before, we have more than 106 years experience working in the English language testing. So we have a very in-depth research and research capability and develop different tests for the different learners. So we have a international respected the quality standard. For example, all of our high stake language tests are monitored under the Ofcall by the UK, and we also the test developer for the very famous global test. It's called IELTS. I think you must know that. And we, at the same time, we ensure the validity and the reliability of our test products to all of the English learners and the test users, and the result widely accepted by the government, education authorities, and employers worldwide. So here is our detailed product portfolio. We call it Cambridge English Qualification. As you can see, it's a well mapping to the CEFR, the Common Europe framework of the references. So actually, we also a developer of the CEFR in the 80s. And we also use the our own the English language scale. It's called Cambridge English Scale. And our product also well mapping to the different language skills domestically. For example, like our CEF Continuing Education Fund, the scale, and the China English Standard scale. So as from the left to right, as you can see, we have the level-based test. We call it the Young Learners, the Mansfield test, and we also have the language test for the high educations, like business certificate English. That test is very welcomed in mainland China and also recognized by our Hong Kong Continuing Education Fund. As you can see from the right of the screen, there is two multi-level tests. One is the very famous test I mentioned, IELTS, and another one is our new product, LinguaSkill. It's just launched in the Hong Kong in the last year, and we got the Continuing Education Fund recognition in this year. You can see the more details on the Continuing Education Fund webpage, and you can check more details of with our HKU Space colleagues. Apart from our Cambridge English test, we also can provide different services and products for the different purpose. For example, we have the Cambridge English teaching, as you can see this well, the green part. So that's we call it teaching qualification test. We provide the TKT, teaching knowledge test, and the CELTA. That's the course for the adult English teachers. And we also have the CELTA P and the CELTA S for the primary school teachers and the secondary school teachers. We also have the different digital learning products provided by our sister business unit, Cambridge University Press, and we also have some apps developed by ourselves. So, and the admission testing, that's the entrance testing for the UK very famous school like Cambridge, Oxford, etc., etc. We also provided the consultancy service from to the government department and to some school level. For example, we have a 5 years consultancy to government program in the Malaysia. We also provide the consultancy services when mainland China National Education and the Examination Authority develops their own English language skill. And we also have the OET that's also very welcomed in Hong Kong. That's an occupational English test that's for the doctor to use English to handle some patient in the hospital. And we also have as per I mentioned before, the CEQ test from the main suite to the back and to the young learners and to the linguistic skill and IELTS. So all of these tests are well mapping to the Common Europe framework references. And every year, basically, we have 5.5 million language learners take our test in more than 170 countries. So that result has been accepted and recognized by more than 25,000 organizations globally. So I think by this way, we open the door to a lifetime of opportunity for each language learners. So we have more than 11,000 higher and future education institutions accept our test and 9,000 employers to accept our test, like some air flight company and some oil petroleum company, etc., etc. And we have more than 500 governments and ministers from the 80 countries to accept our test. So just based on our success, I would like to share some time to talking about our future. You know, we're shaping the future of learning and assessment with some cutting edge technology. So my colleague Darren will introduce more details about the linguistic skill because we apply some AI technology in the writing part, and in the future we also will use the AR marking for the speaking part. So that's very interesting product, and we also apply the computer adapt test technology in the linguistic skill. So next part will be our colleague Darren to introduce more details about our new product linguistic skill, and hope you are interested for that session. And welcome to join this open day. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay, 好多謝田寧先生。我哋跟住落嚟咧，係會有歐先生咧，係幫我哋講解係領思呢一個考檢測嘅。
OK， 唔好喐啊！Okay, so thank you, Leo. So right now we're talk about the overview of our lingual skill. So regarding to this, first of all, if you have any questions, please let me know and we'll answer you at the end from the Q&A section. So regarding to lingual skill, what is lingual skill? Lingual skill is actually an AI empowered assessment test that able to test all four language skills, reading and listening, speaking, and also for writing. You may test only one component or actually all of the components together. So for the test option, we actually do have two options for lingual skills. First of all, of course, which is the general lingual skill test, which it's for our daily English. And for the second one, it's actually for business, which is a test for business language English. So we would like to know that the use for a lingual skill. The use for a lingual skill will separate into two parts. First of all, we're talking about for the higher education sector. First of all, it's for admissions. So most of the school can use it for apply lingual skill for admission use. Second of all, graduation. Third, progression. Scholarship, course placement, and reimbursement. So for example, lingual skill is under the Hong Kong government CEF program. So therefore, it helps promoting English in the region, and that for this program, that it actually works with the reimbursement program here. For the lingual skills sector, for the business sector, basically we do have two main components and two factor use. First of all, it's for recruitment. It's actually for listed as in a benchmark, for English benchmark. And for the second one, it's actually for promotion and to identify training needs for employees. So for this, we know the use for lingual skill, and we would like to know for some of our recognition. Our recognition from, it's actually for a global recognition, but I will list some of it for the Asia Pacific so that it will be more familiar for all of our visitors. So basically the first one, it's actually a CEF from Hong Kong. That is actually one of our biggest recognition for lingual skill in Hong Kong region. That actually, that will support the English language for in the region. Second of all, it's a DHL APAC. This is actually for DHL, they have provided use lingual skill within the APAC region. Air France, that basically to let you know that basically most of the airline, a lot of the airline in global, it's actually will apply lingual skill as one of the benchmark or the training needs for their employees. Bank of Taiwan, finance, it's also one of the sector that we use. University from UK, Cranfield University, they will use it as a benchmark also. Tokyo 2020 Japan, that's Olympics. So basically for Olympics, it's actually we have for Cambridge, we actually been collaborating with Olympics and been using it as a benchmark for a test. Monash University from Australia, same thing as in the university as in a benchmark. And at the end, we have China National United Oil Corp. That actually will also use us as in a recognition and benchmark. So just for example, as you can see how broad and wide that our recognitions are. So why lingual skill? First of all, lingual skill is delivered by expert. As mentioned before, University of Cambridge is actually well known by its research and development team. So lingual skill is actually delivered by the experts. So it's actually designed and developed the whole process, it's actually by them. So this is where it's reliable. Second of all, it's actually been tested with over 40 languages with 50 countries of speakers, so that it ensures the language proficiency and the accents and the different cultural difference will be in factor. Third, fast results. So basically because it's an AI technology base, result will be able to deliver within 48 hours. Full in-depth report. Break down into all four skills with the can-do statement aside. So as you can see from our report aside, we do show a can-do statement for each categories, for each skill set, so that we can ensure that every part of our candidates have a full detailed in-depth report. And also, the main thing is actually aligned with the CEFR. So Cambridge is a key contributor for CEFR with the research and development. Also, it actually is the form of CEFR. So as you can see, all our English Cambridge English qualifications falls under the CEFR, or you can say the Cambridge English Scale benchmark. So lingual skill is aligned to CEFR, also the Cambridge English Scale. So that basically we can actually match through your English skill or your language level based on your lingual skill tests. So after all, it's an advanced computer-based test. So this based on for auto marking, and that's why it can provide you a reliable result with an accurate, reliable result in a fast time, in a short period of time. Advanced computer-based testing. As we mentioned before, that it's an AI test, but why is it advanced? Because it is also adaptive. As in the adaptive, it which allows each candidate to have a unique tailor-made test for to test their English level. This is actually, it's actually from the psychology side, we can also say that it's more efficient and it's actually create less anxiety for the candidates. So TRF verification. This is able to verify all our results from our webpage. So basically, you can log onto our webpage and then check the results, and then for the verification. So now, after that, we'll talk about a little bit about the test features, about how it goes. So first, we'll talk about writing. So writing, we basically break down into two parts, 45 minutes in total. So the first one, you'll be writing around 50 words. Usually, it's writing an email. It's related to an email context. The second one will be words for 180 words. That will take around 30 minutes for this part, and it will be reading a text regarding to a scenario and respond to a letter or a report form. So the next part will be speaking. Speaking will actually, it will be taking only 50 minutes for five parts in total. For this one, the first part will be an interview. After that, it will be reading out aloud. Then, for part three and four, it will be a topic to discuss and talk about for a minute. The fourth will be an intense, advanced discussion that will be actually talking about a graph or a chart for a minute. So for the last one, the fifth part will be actually an opinion with a short response. So basically, so this will be my part, and thank you for your time, and I'll pass the stage back to Cecilia. Thank you.
Okay, 多謝 Darren。 我哋繼續落嚟咧，係睇下劍橋領師英語檢測喺香港大學專業進修學院嘅安排。首先咧，睇下佢哋劍橋嘅大學英語考評啦。咁第一咧就係我自己咧，就喺根據佢哋英語教學同埋評估嘅研究。 建立咗喺歐洲語言通用參考嘅框架（Common European Framework of Reference）。喺左邊咧，你可以睇到係劍橋做咗出嚟嘅一個考量嘅評尺。嗱，呢個評尺相當之緊要嘅。OK， 咁往後咧 ，alright， 我都影響咗喺Hong Kong U-Space 啦嗰個嘅設計課程設計啦等等等等。咁我哋睇下佢嘅考試。 OK， 嗱，你睇到嘅評尺啦，同埋佢哋喺旁邊有好詳盡嘅一啲資料，咁佢哋咧係影響咗 space 裏低課程嘅設計啦。 OK， 我哋每一層嘅由基礎級開始去到精通級咧，都係建基喺 CEFR 呢一個尺上邊嘅。嗱，我哋睇下。 我哋嗰個嘅七層嘅通用英語 ，OK， 咁呢七層咧，你會睇到咧係由 Certificate in General English Foundation 啦基礎級，有Introductory 啦 ，OK， 嗰個進階級、中級、高中級、高階級，然之後流利。 咁當然喺呢度有少少補充嘅，就話，縱使間你喺考試嘅時候咧，你能夠達到 C2 嚇嗰個精通級咧，都不代表你變咗一個外國人嘅。呢個咧大家一定要好小心去處理你嘅考核嘅。但係咧，劍橋任何一個考試咧都提供咗不同嘅目的嘅。 咁所以你睇到我個七層嘅通用英語嘅配合咧，係量度喺右邊黃色嘅咧就係領師。咁較早之前咧係有博士，然之後咧有雅思。咁現存嘅咧就係得翻黃色同埋紅色，即係話領師同埋雅思嘅。 咁雅思咧當然係我哋即係比較係學術級啦，OK， 就嚟入大學嘅多啲。咁但係其他嘅用途咧，我覺得喺量度我哋嗰個嘅英語嘅水平，尤其是嗰個報告咧，我哋會睇到咧係分別作出你嘅聽說讀寫四個能力咧，都有非常清楚嘅演繹嘅喺個報告嗰度。 OK， 咁我哋再睇嗱，呢個係我哋嘅量尺啦。咁我嘅商業英語咧都有異曲同工嘅，但係商業英語咧就因為嗰個嘅分佈嘅關係咧，我哋都係比較闊咗。咁整個 基礎咧就係愛嚟準備一啲基礎級嘅同學，慢慢慢慢咧係讓佢去步向中級。咁由中級至到高中級咧，就係我哋嘅證書班。我哋文憑班同埋高等文憑咧，就會係建基喺我哋會準備學生慢慢由嗰個嘅高階級去到流利級，甚至精通級嘅。OK， 咁喺呢度咧係影響咗 Hong Kong U Space 啦，係選咗個教材啦、教學評估、課程設計同埋開發等等嘅。OK， 咁所以劍橋嘅英語考評以及佢哋開發嘅嗰個嘅CEFR 咧，係非常非常影響我哋深遠。OK， 亦都係好權威嘅。OK。咁我哋以上所有嘅課程咧，都係持續進修基金資助嘅。OK， 咁2019年咧嗰個資助金額咧已經去到20,000蚊。好，我哋繼續咧係關於領師喺香港嘅考核嘅情形。咁2020年4月17日咧，香港大學專業進修學院咧就正式同劍橋英語考評咧係簽署合約，就成為喺香港第一家提供劍橋領師檢測嘅機構。定期開辦一啲檢測嘅時段嘅。2020年5月咧，領師咧就獲得勞工及福利局同埋持續進修基金嘅辦事處批准咧，定為 Hong Kong U Space 持續基金英語課程嘅職業英語基準同埋國際認可嘅測試，係申請學院 CEF 課程資助必須合格嘅一個基準試嚟嘅。好，我哋繼續睇下。呢度顯示咧係學生資助處進修基金相關嘅網頁，有中文有英文啦。咁大家咧有時間咧係可以去睇下嘅。好，咁點樣獲得退款嘅資格呢？咁大家睇睇，首先咧喺新規例底下，咩叫新呢？就係2019年4月1日之後頒發嘅規條咧。第一，學生咧係要填上嗰個同意書啦。第二咧，修讀我哋嘅課程咧，必須要合格50分，好容易嘅其實。第三咧，出席率咧係70%。OK， 咁舉例，如果我哋一個90個課時嘅學習時數咧嘅課程咧，咁你係出席21個小時啦。咁但係咧我哋都希望你出席曬嘅。事實亦都有好多學生咧係完全出席同埋完成我哋嘅網上資源嘅習作等等。OK， 第四咧就係話劍橋領師實用英語嘅檢測。同埋嗰個職場英語檢測咧，是但一個咧，你都要合格嘅。OK， 咁點樣分佈嘅咧？就話我哋通用英語嘅學生就必須要參加 Language Skill General， 即係話實用英語嘅檢測啦。然之後商業英語嘅課程嘅學生咧，就要必須要參加職場英語嘅檢測嘅。OK， 好，每個月嘅時間表咧。我哋通常咧係設喺星期五或者係星期六，咁有啲企業咧就會安排喺星期六啦，因為就唔影響佢哋員工嘅上班時間。咁為咗方便私人嘅考生啦，或者係學校作調配咧，我哋都可以提供其他嘅時間表嘅。咁其他有關嗰個持續進修基金嘅辦學嘅團體咧，都可以聯絡我哋。Okay， 相關的網頁呢，我們都有中文、英文各一的。Okay， 領師通用英語的檢測和商業英語的檢測呢，是有三個模組的。All right， 有閱讀和聽力、口語和寫作。剛才呢，歐先生已經跟我們作了很詳細的解釋，那我這裡不作多講了。但是報考的學生呢是可以申請一次過參加三個檢測或者是單一的檢測，即是說閱讀與聽力一個，口語或者是寫作 Reading, Listening, speaking and speaking 同埋 writing。咁另外咧就係 language skill business 咧都有完全相同嘅分佈嘅，即係話 reading and listening 一張卷啦，speaking 另外一張卷，最後咧你可以參考45分鐘嘅 writing。好，呢度嘅場地啦、時間表啦，咁通用嘅咧喺最近嘅時間表喺7月24日或者係9月25日。商業的部分咧喺8月同埋11月係可以有事舉行嘅，都是星期五。時間表咧7點至9點喺我哋嘅電腦室舉行。OK， 好，成績咧頭先啊歐先生俾咗你睇嗰個資料噶啦，咁我喺呢度不作詳盡嘅睇法啦。但係咧space 咧係會俾你一個 result letter。咁嗰個成績信係點樣嘅咧？係我覺得係好全面地俾大家咧係做一個參考，係方便計劃以後你嘅英語嘅培訓嘅路途係點樣嘅。好啦，我哋睇下嗱，我哋咧第一件事咧就話我哋其實最初喺2002年持續進修基金推出嘅時候咧，我哋係將我哋嗰個嘅課程咧，同埋考到呢個基金贊助嘅試咧信咧，係參分作為歐洲語言考試協會裏邊嘅分部，咁係由零級至到5級加嘅，咁加即係喺個20分裏邊比較高嘅成績啦。咁亦都係咧，會係參考住香港嘅語文教育同埋研究常務委員會，我哋簡稱語常會有分佈咗。嗱，當時咧係將香港嘅工種咧係分開7類嘅，咁由 Pre-1 至到去4高。OK， 咁樣咧就有第三個咧就話最新嘅啦，就是、綠色嘅部分咧就係、是、領先嘅成績。咁我哋咧就一定係參考嗰個嘅歐洲語言框架嗰度嚟到做噶啦。OK， 呢個係不容置疑。OK， 咁最後一樣咧就話點解香港有持續進修基金咧？咁樣樣咁都係因為當時咧喺香港咧係有一個叫做香港嘅職業英語運動，而家咧仲喺嗰個嘅網上有一個特別嘅香港政府嘅網頁係 HK Web。OK， 香港職業英語基準嘅運動所衍生出嚟嘅，時至今日，咁我哋就改為係考呢個嘅領先考試。OK， 好啊，點樣準備咧？呢個都係好多學生有興趣知道嘅。OK， 咁我哋去睇下嗱，劍橋咧喺呢一度咧權威不在話下啦。我今次覺得咧係非常非常之完善嘅一個考試。第一咧，我哋有一個網頁特別嘅網頁咧，係講佢哋嘅考試嘅資訊啦。第二咧，有一啲樣板嘅 OK 嘅考試。第三咧，有練習。嗱，呢啲資源咧係可以幫助你提高閱讀、聽力、寫作同埋口語嘅技能，係一定對於你去參加領先考試，甚至其他嘅考試，劍橋考試都係有好大嘅幫忙嘅。OK， 咁我喺呢度俾3個例子啦。OK， 一咧係有點樣去應付嗰個嘅聽力啦。第二咧點樣應付口語啦？第三咧係點樣應付嗰個閱讀嘅測試嘅 ？OK， 非常非常好嘅一個網站，咁歡迎大家咧隨時都上去瀏覽一下，同埋就算唔考試咧，都係可以提供你嘅水平嘅。最後咧就係話香港大學專業進修學院咧都有為領先考試咧係提供一啲專門嘅服務啦。咁大家可以打呢一個電話同埋嗰個嘅寫電郵俾一啲資訊我哋，咁我哋可以逐一回覆大家。咁另外咧，我哋係根據企業同埋個人嘅要求安排特別嘅測試嘅時段嘅。OK， 歡迎大家係聯絡我哋。咁現在咧，我哋係開始一個問答嘅時段。咁感謝你哋參加今日嘅活動啦。 OK， 咁我哋問答嘅部分咧，有遠在北京嘅田寧先生，歐浩明先生喺我側邊嘅，咁歡迎大家開始提問。
OK， so I have a first question that is the oral part assessed by AI too, Mr. OK. So basically for lingual skill tests.Our oral part, it's actually breakdown in, right now, currently, it's actually using by, for examiner to be assessing the components. But we actually doing into two parts, breakdown into two parts. First, we'll be using the examiner, then we'll use the AI also. Basically, because that right now that there's still accent and different parts that we need to work on, so that right now we're using both. It's not fully AI for the oral part yet.The second question is actually, is the oral part recorded for subsequent application to get back the video? Is the oral part recorded for?
我哋呢度完咗之後咧，我哋呢一個嗰個嘅整個 video 咧，係會擺上去 Hong Kong Newspace Channel 嘅。咁同埋我哋會擺喺我哋嗰個嘅英文科嘅網頁嗰度。咁大家可以到時咧係歡迎瀏覽我哋嘅網頁嘅。
Yep. Okay. So I guess that's it. And any other questions? Can we get the also in claim CF讀緊個 course.
Darren 啊，有同學咧就問，Is the oral part recorded for subsequent application to get back to the to the video？ 我諗佢係問會唔會有錄咗？
佢so basically you're using for the assessment test, we're using the AI part. So give me a second, I will actually type the question for Leo also, so they can actually.Hello, Leo. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Hello, everyone. Good morning, everyone.
Yep.
Morning.
There's a question for you that I am actually typing it down for you. And give me a second. Here we go. Is the oral part recorded for subsequent application to get back the video?
In fact, in our speaking part, we don't need to take video. For that, we only need your microphone, or you can use your computer microphone. We don't take video for the speaking part.
Okay, thank you, Leo. So basically, is that nice and clear? Good.
Yep.
Okay. Other questions?
Not really.
Lingual skill general. What's the difference between lingual skill general and lingual skill business? So first of all, lingual skill is testing our language skills. So basically the component, it will be still four parts of components, reading, listening, speaking, and writing. But however, the part, it will be different by the content. So because as in daily life English and also for business language, that will be the difference. For example,looking at graph, increase, decrease, percentage, these will be kind of like more business focused, business orientated. For daily wise, it will be another use of language. So that will be the difference between general and business language for the lingual skill tests.
I think I can provide a few other comments about this good question. I think this is a very good question.
Okay.
I think maybe most our English learners in Hong Kong are familiar with our bullets. So for the lingual skill business part, actually it's an upgrade version of the bullets. And for the lingual skill general, our purpose of developing this test is aiming at to service more English learners in the different segmentation. Another reason behind that is,So we need to ensure the validity of our test. So cognitive validity is a very key component of the validity framework. For example, so if we test a candidate who are in the high school, but he or she does not have any, you know, business background, so that issue, if we use the linguistic business to test them, the issue will impact the cognitive validity of our test. So that's why we developed the language skill general for the different segmentation candidates.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so and then we have another question that upcoming. It's actually, can UK university accept lingual skill tests? Yes, can UK university accept lingual skill test result as university entrance requirement? So from this question, basically it really depending for this language skill, it's actually used for a language test, and it during this time of period, it actually depending on universities. So different universities have a different approach with the use of lingual skill tests. Some universities do use it as in an acceptance for the entry university entries requirement. So for this part, you must carefully check the university website to make sure that the requirement and benchmark is aligned with the university benchmark.
As far as we know, some of universities in the UK, they have accepted the language skill as their entrance requirement.
Yes.
Entrance requirement in this special period. For example, like Cranfield University, so they have accepted language skill as the language certificate in their entrance requirement. So yes, like Darren said, we suggest that you can check the website of the UK university. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they will show if they can accept the lingual skill, or you can check their administration office about this question.
No problem. Thank you. So general and business, are they having the same qualification and recognition? Yes. Basically, for a lingual skill, it is actually, you can say general and business is two components under the lingual skill test. So therefore, they actually have the same recognition and the same benchmark for the lingual skill test.
Yeah, that's a really good question. We can share our strategy for the recognition. Basically, we don't separate the lingual skill business and the lingual skill general as a two brand. So we just promote the lingual skill as a one brand of our product.
Yep.
So from the recognition strategy, we prefer don't distinguish lingual skill or business or lingual skill general.
Okay, no problem. Okay, Leo, there is an interesting question for you. Can this qualification recognized by immigration department?
I would like to say so far, as far as I know, to my best knowledge, there is no any immigration department accept the lingual skill, because for such kind of test, if they accept, take UK as an example, if you know, for the IELTS, now they have the UK VIELTS, and another our product like OET has been accepted by Australia Immigration Department. They have a number of the different requirements. But for the lingual skill, actually our positioning is a mid-stake test rather than, you know, high-stake test like IELTS or our OET. But if you want to use the some of our product for the immigration purpose, we suggest you can take our upper management test, like the C1 Advanced or C2 Proficiency. That has been recognized, especially for the C2 Advanced, has been recognized by UK government and Australia and the New Zealand government. Yep.
Okay. Can you explain more on TRF verification? So for TRF verification, it's basically once you complete your lingual skill exam, your lingual skill test, basically you have your record. So in order for validity and to check the reality and reliability of the test. So basically, we do have a website from a Cambridge webpage that you can check the test result and the candidate's result from the website.
So for the TRF website, I think one of our purpose behind that is, you know, the lingual skill basically is a online test. right? Rather than the paper-based test, you know, we want to conduct our social responsibility, you know, to provide a environment-friendly test. That's a new way we tried it. But we also have some challenge because, you know, if we do the, we issue the paper certificate to you, so it's a look like a certificate. You can use that certificate you have passed the language skill. But for the language skill, we only show our results on your account, and you can share the digital certificate to the test user. But sometimes test users feel that it's not reliable from their perspective. So that's why we developed the website to help test user and our candidates, you know, to prove they really passed the test. That's our key purpose behind that.
Okay. Can we get the PowerPoint for sharing with our colleagues to apply for the course together? Yes, basically for that, after the open day, basically you can reach out to Hong Kong Uspace and we can discuss, they will share the PPT slide afterwards with you. Can this, and then let me see. Any expiry date for the certificate? Because IELTS valid period, it's for 3 years only.
So far, we don't have an expiry date for the language skill certificate.
Yep, so basically this one, I would say for this one, is right now it's actually for a long period of time. It will be different compared to IELTS at this stage. May I know how to apply lingual skill? In order to apply to lingual skill, you may reach out to Hong Kong Uspace, as beside we have Cecilia Gak right here. So for you can inquire and then learn more about lingual skill and for the application. Okay, let me see, is there any other questions? Okay, give me a second, there's some questions. What are the difference between lingual skill tests and IELTS? Lingual skill general and IELTS academic. What are the difference?
I think so. There are basically, we would like to see there are two different exam products. Let me see. So what's the same? What's the same part of the language skill and the IELTS? So they are the multi-level test. So it means that they can test you from the A1 to C1 plus. Both of them. So what's the difference between the two tests? One, I think the way of the delivery. IELTS, so they have two way of the delivery. One is the paper-based and another one is the computer-based. And for the language skill, we only deliver the test from the computer-based with our cloud technology. So the second difference between the IELTS and the language skill is the, you know, the logic and the theory we applying into the these two our key products. For the IELTS, you know, it's the linear test. It's like, you know, you have different parts. You need to finish all of the questions from the beginning to the end, but the question will not be changed. But for the language skill, we are using a computer adapting technology. That means that, you know, the next question will based on the answer of your current question. I think that's the key difference between the lingual skill and IELTS. The third is from our product positioning strategy. For the IELTS, they are high-stake tests. As I mentioned before, you can use it for the immigration purpose. For the lingual skill, we are aiming to provide a more easily delivered product for more and wide our
target
learners. Yes.
Yep. Okay. So I guess that's most of the question. Is there any more questions from anyone on the floor?
我答翻其頭先一位同啊一位啊唔啊 朋友嘅一個問題咧，就係幾時可以去考試，令到你可以申請到持續進修基金嘅退款咧？咁樣樣，咁咧就嗱，唔係一定要讀曬課程先至去考試嘅，係冇規定。但係我個人嘅意見咧，就話你讀曬個課程咧，其實是你的語言能力最高峰，因為你的老師會有幫助你，或者你有來參加我的備試的一些講座，你會知道，哦，我入到市場，我會見到這些、這些、那些，然後我就作答，這樣，好過你冒冒然走進去，你又沒有準備，你又衝進去考呢，OK，還有可能，為什麼你要讀課程呢？就因為你感覺到自己語言能力的不足嘛，你才會去參加一些課程，然後你去拿基金的錢，這樣，所以我都仍然是覺得學生呢是讀了一個課程完成咗啦，跟住我哋嘅時間表，如果你係 space 嘅學生嚇，咁你就嚟考核，OK，會比較恰當啲，OK。雖然過往咧，我哋都有啲同學咧，因為趕住移民，咁佢就提早會考咗試啊，然之後咧就我哋又開一場當時係 bullet 啦，博士咁樣就俾佢即係喺移民之前去可以遞到佢嘅申請啊，等等等等咁樣。咁同學如果有一啲問題咧，其實真係即管聯絡我哋嗰個熱線，OK，咁變咗我哋係可以個別咧係瞭解咗你嗰個問題，然之後咧先至幫你解決，咁係即係我覺得好得嘅，OK，咁原本教學啊語文嘅水平嘅測試啊等等咧，都係一啲同人有關嘅嘢，所以咧就即管打電話俾我哋。OK， 咁答咗你嘅題目就話不一定要讀曬，但係我哋係建議你讀曬先至去參加嗰個考核咧，係會比較我會話高分啲咯咁樣樣，即係呢個係我咁多年喺公開試嗰個經驗而得嘅。OK， 其實學生咧離開學校之後十年，如果佢冇繼續去進修或者冇繼續揾到一啲能夠用到英語嘅地方咧，佢係跌嘅佢個語文，任何語文都係一樣。OK， 咁所以每週你都揾一啲時間去練習英語，所以頭先我去劍橋嗰個嘅備試嘅網站嗰度，我咁緊張就話：哇！我話呢啲係好嘢嚟，通通你就算唔係考領師、雅思乜嘢都好，你都係會發覺你跟住佢做，跟住佢聆聽，跟住嗰個講解咧，一定係好大好大嘅益處嘅咁樣樣。咁都補充頭先問有一個朋友咧，係問點樣去申請領師考試，咁我頭先都講咗啦，就話我哋定期喺七月、八月、九月同埋十一月咧，都係有一個考試嘅。Alright， 四個月。咁其他咧，如果你話啊，我好急趕啊，我好驚啊，我又即係要攞個分數去愛嚟升職加薪嘅咁樣樣，咁我哋過往都有經驗係真係會幫咗學生係做一場特別嘅考試，等佢可以符合到佢哋公司嘅要求、僱主嘅要求或者係考試嘅要求咁樣樣。OK， 咁希望幫到你。OK。
OK，so。So there is a question that for Leo, there's actually one question that's pretty interesting that they're saying that because the questions will not be linear, but based on our questions provided by previous questions. So how can fairness across candidates be ensured by respective mechanisms? So I believe that she wants to talk about and discuss about the adaptive test system.
I think that's a...It's a big question. So, you know, the Cambridge Assessment English, we have a thought leadership in the computer adapting test. Actually, just in the last week, we delivered a webinar to talking about, there is a full webinar, one session to talking about the computer adapting test. So we will publish the video on our Facebook and LinkedIn social media platform. I think that video is the best resources to can answer your question. Please follow our Facebook page and our LinkedIn page.
I agree, Leo. Yes, so basically for this question, it's actually a really big question because it's actually discussing about our development of the adaptive system. So for this one, we actually do have our leadership skill, as in the experts from LinguaSkill that they actually did a webinar to discuss about the validity and also the question that you're talking about, the adaptive test. So we will be uploading it on our Facebook page later on. If you're interested, please follow our Facebook page, and we will contact you and share it upon that later in the later future. And Leo, one more thing is because it's almost time, really, and I know that it's your holiday today. Really, thank you for your time to attending the open day for us, and thank you for the support.
Okay.
Thank you, Leo.
I think it's a really good opportunity, you know, to communicate with our Hong Kong English learners. I also learned so much from your questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Leo.
Thank you, Leo. Have a good day. Take care.
You too.
Yep. Thank you. Bye-bye.
OK， 仲有幾條題目我想喺呢度答咗嘅。OK， 咁呢個同學咧就問同一個試可以考幾多次？有冇限住某一個時段？其實係冇嘅。OK， 你即係只需要咧係準備咗嚟咧，其實個試真係唔難嘅。OK， 我覺得係有可以好大嘅支援喺嗰個網站上邊。如果你有問題，隨時都聯絡我哋。OK， 咁個試咧係當然你唔可以一日考到，即係我嘅經驗係你唔可以一日考好多啦。因為你做完嗰個嘅閱讀同埋聽力之後咧，都85分鐘，講緊都你嚟市場都會逗留上緊2個鐘咁樣樣。咁你個人係好攰嘅，你唔應該諗住一日考曬佢或者考好多。咁你可以隔一段時間温下書先至再考。所以任何安排考試咧，就唔好等到你嗰個嘅持續進修基金嗰、那個户口咧係到期啦。你知舊制係有4年嘅限期。你先至嚟考試咧，咁樣我覺得係非常之不智咯。OK， 早少少你量度咗自己嗰、那個，哦，原來個報告出嚟咧係話你個 speaking 係不及於你嗰個嘅聽同埋閱讀嘅，咁你咪往後嘅日子你就專攻你個 speaking 或者專攻你個 writing 咁樣樣。OK， 咁呢個係我覺得幾緊要嘅。OK， perhaps you can answer Darren。What accent can we learn? Okay, British, US, Australia.
We're not
international, right?
We're not really learning accent here. It's a LinguaSkill test. It's basically cover up everything that it's actually most of them. It's for the skill set. So that's why I said in the beginning for the speaking part, accent is a part of consideration for these tests because that there's different accent, but language is still the same. That's the main point. Yep. And if I believe that it's almost time. So basically, if you have any other questions, please let us know. You may send us an email or you can actually reach me out from Cambridge website. We can discuss more later on. I look for, thank you for your time and thank you for letting me attend the open day. Thanks, Cecilia.
最後，我代表劍橋大學同埋香港大學專業進修學院咧，係感謝大家參加呢個活動。OK， 多謝，再見。
Thank you.